In this video, we'll further explore the bifurcation diagram and see some of the complexities and patterns that it holds. So here again is the website that plots the bifurcation diagram for us, and I've resized it so that it fits more or less in the screen. So the first thing just to call attention to, as we've already seen, is that this period doubling repeats again and again. So period doubling, here we have period 1 behavior, and that goes over to period 2 as R is increased, and then period 4, and then period 8. And we see that period doubling again and again in, sorry, I'm having a hard time with the mouse here. We see that period doubling again and again as we zoom in. So here I've zoomed in a bunch. Let's zoom in, this region here. And there is a period doubling again. I'm going to zoom in here. And now I'm starting to lose resolution. I'm sort of missing some points. So I'm going to plot 2000 instead of 200. And I'll zoom in here. Oops, let me try that again. See what's see what's going on in that square. And we're seeing this feathering or smearing, so probably I should skip some more points because it's taking longer to reach the long-term behavior. So I'll try skipping 1,000 points before the plotting begins. And that clears that up. And now maybe I'll try plotting 10,000 points. It's going to take a little while, hopefully not too long. That sort of darkens it up. And let's zoom in a little bit more. Let's see what's going on right up here. Try that again. All right, so let's zoom in there. Period doubling again. Let's zoom in there. Again, starting to see some smearing out. So I'm going to now skip 10,000 before I start plotting. And that crisps things up again. And I'll try doing one more zoom. There I go. I'll zoom in. And I need a few more points, so I'm going to plot now 20,000 points. Maybe I'll do a little more. Maybe I'll do 40,000, make it a little bit darker. And then I'm going to now skip plotting, 20,000. And that should, a little bit, clear up that smudge. Maybe I'll skip 40,000 now. So for each final state diagram, it iterates for 40,000 and then plots the next 40,000. And here's the pattern that we see. So this looks a lot like, very, very similar to a larger portion of the bifurcation diagram. So this has a certain fractal structure to it in that we see small copies of the whole, the large object. And we've zoomed in a tremendous amount. So check out the difference from the range of R values that we're looking at. 3.743244828 to 3.743244852. So it's only in the last three digits that there's a difference here. So let's think actually for a moment about just what a small range this is. Let's see if we can come up with a way to visualize this. So on the bifurcation diagram that I just showed on the screen, the R value started at this and ended at that. So they're very, very close together. Let's see what the difference is between these two. But to do that, I'm going to have to subtract, and I'm not very good at subtraction, but let's see if I can do this. 2 minus 4, I need to borrow a 1. 12 minus 4, let's see, that's 8. Then that 5 turned into a 4. 4 minus 8, I need to borrow a 1. Let's see, 14 minus 8 is a 6. And then I've got 2 minus 2. And lots of zeros. So that's a very, very small number. Let's see, how, let's put in a scientific notation that may be helpful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is 6.8 times 10 to the minus 9. A tiny, tiny, tiny range. So if we imagine we're measuring R, we usually think of that as a growth rate, but to make this more concrete, if we think about this in terms of meters, this would be 6.8 or about 7 nanometers. And that's, so that's the range. We're looking at this bifurcation diagram over a range of about 7 nanometers, and that's it's tiny, maybe about the size of a large molecule, several large molecules. We've zoomed in a tremendous amount, is the point I'm trying to make. And here's another way to think about this, how much we've zoomed in. So in the current zoom in on the screen we were looking at before we came over to this piece of paper, we had an R range of this, 6.8 times 10 to the minus 9. And that took, I'm going to say, 10 centimeters. So on my laptop screen where I was shooting that, maybe the image was about 10 centimeters across. And on your, depending on how you're watching the video, it might be a little bit smaller. If you're experimenting on a screen, it might not be exactly this size. But the point is, we're just trying to get an order of magnitude estimate. It's closer to 10 centimeters than 1 or 100. So this was the scale we're in now. And suppose we wanted to view the entire bifurcation diagram at this scale. So, right, so this 6.8, that was an R range. If we wanted the R range to be 4, how many centimeters would that be? Well, so it's going to be very, very large. We've zoomed in so much that the bifurcation diagram is now very, very large. It zoomed off the screen many, many, many times. So let's see how large it is. So let's solve for this question mark. So I can cross multiply and divide, and I would get the following. The size of the So at this scale, the size of the original bifurcation diagram would be 5.9 times 10 to the 9 centimeters. That's almost 6 billion centimeters, which is about 5,900 kilometers. So that would be a huge distance. And to put that in perspective, the circumference of the Earth is only 40,000 kilometers. So to recap, what this means is, we started with a bifurcation diagram that went from 0 to 4. And we zoomed in again and again and again, and we kept seeing this pitchfork structure, this branches that split into branches that split into branches. We saw that at different places in the bifurcation diagram. And we kept zooming in and zooming in and zooming in until we saw one of those pitchforks, one of those splittings, over this very, very tiny range of R values. And at that point, we'd zoomed in enough that the original diagram would have gotten so large that it would have stretched around the Earth's circumference. So we're zooming in an almost unimaginable amount into this mathematical object, this bifurcation diagram, and we're seeing these structures repeat again and again and again. So here's the bifurcation diagram again, and if this bifurcation diagram is about 10 centimeters on your screen, this small, tiny, tiny little portion of the full bifurcation diagram looks to be about 10 centimeters, then at this magnification, the full bifurcation diagram from R equals 0 to R equals 4 would stretch around the circumference of the Earth. All right, let's zoom back out. Imagine we've zoomed in a great deal. So I'm hitting the back button again and again. Out we go. And there's the original bifurcation diagram. In fact, it's even a little made a little larger. Now let's go forward. Let's zoom back in just to sort of see that one more time. So zooming in. Some of these steps increase resolution or the number of points I skip. Zooming in more and more, the full diagram gets larger and larger as I do so. And let's see, there was the last step. So at this magnification, the full bifurcation diagram stretches around the Earth.